Guten Tag. My number is Thavaraj. My name is Thavaraj. That's in German, by the way. So I'm 30 years old. I'm a civil engineer by profession.
Hey, mate. How are you?
Hello.
Nice to meet you. How are you?
I'm Gary, 25 years old. One day, I bring my friend to Mama and watch semi-final of Champions League. Still remember that day, Dortmund literally thrashed Real Madrid.
Watching a match, you can see a sea of yellow wall.
My name is Amirul Azvi bin Abdul Aziz.
Hey, Amirul, how are you doing? Nice to meet you, Mark.
Hi, Amirul, Reem, nice meeting you.
I am glad to announce to everyone of football fans in Malaysia that I'm the actual Borussia Dortmund fans.
My name is Yuwa. I've been a Dortmund fan since 1997.
I adore the fans in the stadium, definitely. It's the most intimidating for away fans.
Hey, BVB. Hey, BVB. Hey, 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 BVB.
Hello, I'm Praveen. I'm 19 years old. I started supporting because of Jurgen Klopp. I admire his playing style. The player I admire the most is Marco Reus.
Reus, he always wears his right shin guard, his right boots and right socks first. Before wearing the left one, and always steps into the pitch, which is left foot.
This is tough. Quite tough.
Like, each one of them has got their own right to come.
But I think we both agree on one guy, right? Like, it's unanimous. Like,
this guy here.
Yeah, the minute he came in, we just loved his energy.
And I think he is the one, so should we call him in?
Let's call all of them in and break the news.
Judgment time. Hey, guys.
Hey, guys.
So guys, firstly, thank you all so much for coming. I think we've done a good job in picking the top five biggest Dortmund fans here in Malaysia. And if we could take all of you, we would. But unfortunately, we can only bring one person. And you all have your equal rights for coming to this trip. Gary, for instance, I mean, you were so passionate about Dortmund. I could really feel it.
Yeah, Praveen, I like the fact that you knew about Marco Reus's rituals before he started the match. So that was really good.
I really love the fact that when I asked you about the stadium and you talked about it, I could just imagine you being there. I think that was really awesome.
Yeah, on that note, Raj, I can imagine you like singing along with all the fans because you knew all the songs, even the ones in German. And the fact that you speak German, that's a plus, so yeah.
Speaking about singing, Amirul, you even created a song for us and sang it.
So, you, Gary and Praveen, can you please step forward? Unfortunately, neither of you are coming with us to Dortmund. Two of you, please step forward. Amirul, as Mark mentioned, you're very passionate and that the fact that you would orchestrate a whole new song and make like everyone sing with you, we really love that. I don't know, I guess there's no other way to say this, but Raj, you're coming with us to Dortmund.
Congratulations,
Raj. Amirul, you came really close and the rest of you, we will be bringing back souvenirs from Dortmund, okay?
And seriously, guys, thank you all so much for coming. You are all equally amazing Dortmund fans in your own right, but we can only bring one
Raj,
person.
Congratulations. So,
I'm so happy.
I'm very eager to meet the whole Borussia Dortmund team, especially Marco Reus, Mats Hummels, Shinji Kagawa, and Emre Aubameyang.
My biggest sporting wish is to witness Super Bowl in the USA. Nothing will ever beat that.
I wish I could watch an NBA match courtside. Delavadova, please.
We are finally here in Germany. Okay, after 16 hours journey, we are finally here in the hotel. I'm still very surprised on what is happening. I don't even know what's the itinerary, so I hope for the best. I'm very excited, definitely, to be here in Germany. Nice hotel, nice setup. I hope, I just hope for the best then.
choosing Dortmund, but before you start your Dortmund experience, we are going to show you a little bit of history about German football.
Okay. Yes, we feel like before you go to Dortmund, you should get some more German knowledge. So here's one ticket for you, one ticket for you, Reem. I think we should check out some Deutschland history.
Deutschland Fußball.
Whoa.
Oh, looks nice.
It's massive, right?
German world champions. Oh, definitely excited.
In the Football Museum, I learned a lot of things about the German football club, what made them world champions in the World Cup. Their team spirit and the impressive facilities that they have for the German football national team, and the coherence and the closeness they have among all the players and understanding among all the players is just simply amazing. I guess they have all the recipes to be the world champions at that time.
You're supposed to stop and defend. Hello, Raj. Defend.
Come on, Raj.
Defend. Defend.
Go in.
Oh my God, Mark, you suck. Come on, Earth.
Yay!
Goal number one.
Good goal, dude. Bye.
They're gonna hit it back at you.
Woo! Wow.
You guys are just getting thrashed, okay?
Whoa. So good.
Redeemed
yourself. Yeah, good. Very good. Danke.
That's good.
Danke.
That's good.
Very good.
Come.
What's up, man?
Danke.
You guys got thrashed.
Did you see that? It's like
my kids. I think half your age. I'm embarrassed for you.
It's a mini little
Nelson. We managed to equalize, though.
No. Those kids had you. Ooh, check out that
bus. The German national team bus.
The official one, isn't it?
Nice.
Yeah.
Wow. Yes. Mercedes.
They are my special.
Quicker, we can go inside.
Let's go.
I mean, yeah.
Yeah,
pathetic.
Those kids were good.
Pathetic. Wow. Leather seats.
It's the national bus.
This is where
Mario Götze
seats. This is where Götze sits.
This is the dream team.
The best players get the tables.
Where's the dream team sitting?
Probably in the best seats with the tables.
In the best seats.
Right.
The last seats with tables.
These ones. Okay.
Do you think this is reserved like the best players? You know, like, these seats are a bit normal and now they've got the tables.
Yeah.
Do you think the Götze? They sit here.
So all the rookies sit in front, but you know, the...
So Reem, this is for me and...
I'm your manager, so. So now that you are well educated on German history,
my first international cap.
Maybe it would be good to learn more about your wonderful dream club, Dortmund.
Yeah. I think it's time to get the black and yellow fever on. Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go. Come on.
Say goodbye to the German
bus. Let's go. It's time to head.
Borussia Dortmund!
Signal!
Iduna Park!
The German fans are gonna be out here. Do you want some? I'll cover you from there. No pictures!
No pictures!
Yeah.
Danke!
This way, guys.
Hey, so what a wonderful experience today at the German Football Museum. Saw a lot of memorabilia, a lot of new things about the German Football Club, a lot of new information that I've learned. So what Mark and Reem told me that is that tomorrow we'll be going through the entire process of how the BVB goes through the pre-match preparation for the upcoming matches. Usually, I always see them on television during matches, but now probably I get to experience what they do pre-match, and especially during their pre-match preparations for the upcoming match. So let's see how it goes then.
Raj, this is where the magic happens. This is where they train before game day. Oh. But all the players train here, right, Mark?
Yeah, we have the youth team over here, so they train on this. And this is where they find the new wonder kids. So the new Matt Hummels and Marco Rices. This is where they find them and train.
Oh, do you see the black and yellow jerseys?
Marco Rice, Shinikagawa.
The whole team, wow. The whole team are here.
Oh man, I'm so excited.
Brace yourself.
I didn't expect to see the players. And then when Reem and Mark brought me there, I was seeing my idols for first time training, and it's just simply amazing. I see the whole squad was there. Oh, I see
this
some
is
people.
Exclusive access here, by the way.
Oh, oh my God.
Nice.
Ooh, look at them, look at them.
Royce. You're not going to run on the pitch, right?
The first team. Oh, they're here, they're here.
Wow. Oh, let's go.
Oh, there's... I see Aubameyang. Oh, there's Hummels. Gundogan, let's see if we find Royce. Oh, that's Royce. My God. It's awesome.
You should take pictures with all the youth players. You never know, one day there might be a superstar.
Yeah.
Here you go in. Are we allowed in? Cool, wasn't it?
It's exactly how I expected
yeah.
it.
Yeah, you know, honestly, when you were telling me about it, I imagined like an actual robot. I don't know why.
We are going to head over now to the press conference to see what the team have got to say about the match on Saturday.
I have lots of questions for them.
Ooh, okay.
Hello.
When we were talking to Burki, all of a sudden we see Aubameyang coming out from his car and messing around with Burki's car. That was funny.
Okay, he's doing a joke. Our winner from Malaysia. He's a big fan of Borussia Dortmund and of you, of course. Do you want to take a photo? Come, let's take a photo of you guys together. Alright, one more. Thank you.
Thank you.
Number one fan from Malaysia.
Okay. Do you want to take a group photo for Wishlist?
Yes.
Watching you training today. Awesome.
All the best this Saturday.
Thank you very much.
Sorry.
This Saturday again?
Yeah.
This Saturday? Oh, you watch?
Thank you very much.
Danke.
Ciao, Baruki. Ciao, Baruki.
Ciao.
Ciao, ciao.
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 Thank you.
Thank you.
Dai, auto capute.
Kaput. The car, your car is spoiled. Wiki, your car is broken. So that was a very funny experience, and to see the other lighter side of the players, you know, it's just an unforgettable experience for me.
Do you recognize
me? Thank you.
Come on.
So cool. Look at your face, you're so happy.
Thank you.
Are you going to frame this?
Yes,
definitely.
Yeah, for our collector, this means a lot, right?
Collector's merchandise.
He's a happy boy.
I was very lucky to get the signatures as well.
Oh, I tell you what, that was pretty cool. I'm not going to lie.
So
I didn't understand a word what they said, but thanks for translating, mate.
Everything was in German, though.
Good job. So, you know, we saw the press conference, we saw the guys training, you got to meet Shinji Kagawa, dude.
I didn't expect Matt would stop and entertain the fans, but he, among all the players, he entertained all the fans. He actually signed every single one of every single jersey that was given to him. You can really see that Matt's a very nice person. I know there are a lot of news about him, but for me, I believe that the club is always bigger than the player. Matt has contributed a lot to the team, so I think we can let him go, and probably we definitely will get someone to replace him.
You know what, we've seen the playful side of these footballers. I think it's time to watch them battle on the pitch,
yes,
right?
Yes, it's happening tomorrow.
So we need to go and rest up, yes. Get ready for
we'll
the match tomorrow.
We'll need all the energy we have.
Can't wait for that.
I started following Borussia Dortmund since 1997. You can really see that how the club has developed throughout the years, since the likes of Andreas Möller, Jürgen Koller, Lars Rickens during the UEFA Champions League finals. Then throughout the years, they didn't do so well, but they did have a lot of good players like Jan Koller, Tomas Rosicky. Then I learned even more about the title-winning squad of Jürgen Klopp, you know, where we had amazing players like Mario Götze, Lewandowski. It's what a Borussia Dortmund fan would have asked for, you know. The Borussia is just amazing. It really showcased the club as a whole and how the club evolves and how the city evolves around the club and what major role the club plays in a city like Dortmund. And that really shows me that everyone around this City loves the club very, very much, and they have a lot of international fans as well. You can see a lot of Japanese fans around the museum, and it's definitely a three-dimensional experience in the Borussia because you get to sing along. Sing, and you also get to see a lot of audio and visual effects from very long time ago. So it's definitely a very good and a complete experience.
Nice to meet you, man.
I'm Jonas.
Meet you. You
want
to take us around?
Yes, I will. I'm really looking forward for the next 90 minutes, or 60 minutes approximately. And I want to show you the most beautiful stadium in the world, of course.
Yes.
That's it. The Signal Iduna Park. Okay. And we'll just start right away. I will just show you the most important areas of the stadium. First, we go inside the media tunnel. This is where the team arrives before every game.
Hey. Let's go.
The media tunnel is always a good opportunity to make the connection between today and the past of Borussia Dortmund, because we have a very good inside view inside the old stadium of Borussia Dortmund. This is where Borussia Dortmund played from 1937 until 1974. It's called the Red Ground Arena, die Kampfbahn Rote Erde. Maybe today in the direct comparison it seems very small and maybe unimportant. But it has a great part, it earns a great part in the history of Borussia Dortmund. We are in the mixed zone of the stadium. This is where, after the game, in a few hours, the interviews will be produced. There will be up to 60 journalists here and 10 to 12 camera teams. And they all want the players to stop by and answer some of their questions. You can see these yellow lines.
Yeah.
And in these lines, or in these boxes, the TV teams are organized. This is, of course, national television, German television, RAD, ZDF, Sport 1, and so on and so forth, but, of course, international television as well.
Compared to other clubs, as we can see, the players' dressing room at Borussia Dortmund is very simple. It is a standard changing room. But what's most important is that the team is together and they will play their best and give their all in that 90 minutes. So everyone's focused on the team and focused on the game at hand rather than having flashy equipment. Because it's a standard, what I would say is a standard changing room where the players come being focused and then they just go and win the games in hand. In the Signal Iduna Park really give me goosebumps because you can see the South Terrace, you can see all the places which I can only see on television during the Bundesliga matches. Seeing all the special access places is definitely an unforgettable experience for me.
All right, guys, before we get wet, I would suggest that I will show you your seats. The game will start in a few hours, so we're pretty much done with our tour. Hope you enjoyed it. I will now show you seats, and let's go there, right? Come on.
Pre-match entertainment was there. There were a lot of people around the stadium buzzing. Everyone was cheering, everyone was chanting, building up the atmosphere for the match. There are a lot of hot dog stands, food being sold around the stadium. And then when we head in, you know, you can really see the South Terrace. You know, they started, they came, all of them came early, and then they'll start cheering right from the start. And it's simply amazing, you know, you see the South Stand, it's really an intimidating sight if you're an opponent. It's an amazing score of 5-1 against Wolfsburg. We see Kagawa scoring. Here we see Ramos scoring. Aubameyang scoring 2 goals. He could almost got an hat-trick, but 5-1 was an amazing score for us. Although it's everything in German, but you can really see the post-match conference where everything was very tense. You can see that the coach was very happy with the scoreline, 5-1. Despite the win, I think a lot of mixed emotions in the post-match press conference. So, the way Thomas Tuchel handled it was very professional. I could really see a side of the coach where he is very he's very direct.
We are now taking questions for Dortmund's biggest fan.
How's your experience been?
Absolutely amazing.
That'll be it. Thank you very much.
Cheers.
It's definitely an experience where I cannot expect to get, you know, watching in the television, but every single emotion was running around towards, was running in my body, and I'm definitely very excited. I'll definitely be back again at this beautiful ground and to show my support to the Borussia. One thing for sure about Wishlist, there were a lot of surprises, which is so exciting.
So Raj, man, you've been to the training ground, you've met some of the players.
You've had the game.
Yeah.
It's been such a great experience.
You've got to go to the stadium tour, you've got to go to the museum.
I've done everything.
No, not everything, because we are here at the club store.
Yeah, yes. Shopping at football too,
shopping
my favorite
for merchandise of my beloved.
Borussia Dortmund.
Yes, it is. And you know what, Raj? We decided to like stir things up a little bit, okay?
Okay.
As a gift to you, we actually want you to go for a little shopping spree.
And this has never been done before.
A little shopping spree in this Fanwalt store right here. And but there's a little twist to it, Luck. Okay. There's a little twist to this shopping spree, and I'm gonna give you the instructions. Make sure you listen closely because I'm not gonna repeat myself, okay?
Okay.
We're gonna give you 45 seconds, you know, like a football game. The first half is 45 minutes, but 45 seconds. You can pick whatever you want in the store, but you only have 45 seconds.
Okay.
And the second rule is that you cannot pick two of the same item. So for example, right, if you like go to the keychain shelf, you can only pick one of each keychain.
45 seconds.
And it can only be Dortmund stuff, remember?
Only Dortmund stuff. Yeah. So, and another thing is, you have to be back at the cashier within that 45 seconds. Because if you're not there...
I won't be able to pay for the stuff.
We're not going to pay for that stuff, okay? So, 45 seconds, take as much things as you can. Remember, you cannot take two of the same items.
Dortmund stuff only.
Whatever you have to do, you have to be back here in 45 seconds, okay? 3, 2, 1, go!
Go!
45 seconds! Ten seconds in. 11, 15 seconds. Remember, only one of each item. Get the right size. 20 seconds in. You're up at 30 seconds. I think you better run down right now.
Everything was, a lot of things were running through my head.
Oh no, I can't find the escalator.
Oh no, oh no, okay.
It was a very short period of time. I was very afraid I couldn't meet the time being given. So I was like running here and running there, and like time is almost up. So I ran around like a crazy guy. Everyone was looking at me.
You need to be at the cashier in 10 seconds.
Yeah! You made it! Oh man, so what'd you get?
So in the 45 seconds I was given, I managed to grab the home jersey, the away jersey. I took two of the scarves, and also took the DFB Pokal T-shirt, which would be worn during the finals against Bayern Munich. Everything that I wanted to get, I was lucky enough I managed to get it. So it's definitely a very good experience, and also I was very, very shocked at the moment. Overall, this experience has been simply amazing, you know, the ultimate Borussia Dortmund experience. First of all, I'd like to thank Mark and Reem for being such amazing hosts. They really made this trip so much fun.
Why? Should I try and provide entertainment and I get this? God, now I'm gonna be even more cold. See, I try to entertain you guys, and this is what I get for it, yeah?
Not funny.
Yeah?
I wanted to bring this inside.
Oh, I'm gonna be really cold now, aren't I? Oh.
Don't get this shot.
Why?
Get this shot.
Why is it? Why is this?
That is how you got
I really learned a lot from this experience, and I would like also like to thank the Wishlist crew, Wishlist team, and Astro for giving me this opportunity of a lifetime to be in Dortmund witnessing a match, such a wonderful match, as well as giving me so many surprises. It's definitely an amazing experience for me, and I'd like to thank all of you guys for such a wonderful experience. And traveling around for these past few days has been simply amazing. And if I could do it again with you guys, I'd definitely do it again.
Succedere, chiamami se senti paura o freddo.
Reem, putting your shirt on the sh.
Seriously, there's one here.